by amazing people. My name is Nick, and as of requested by many people, here is the tips and tricks to the challenges for the Phantom Reagan Infinite Warfare. So if you're new to my channel, this is your first time watching one of these videos from me, this is a series where I did all the rigs and giving you guys tips and tricks to completing the challenges for all the rigs. I will pop a link at the end of this video to give you guys the playlist for all of them. I did the Warfighter, Merc, Synaptic, FTL, and Striker, and here's the final one, the Phantom Rig. But basically in this video, I'm going to be giving you guys tips and tricks to completing these challenges the easiest way possible. And just a quick note, these are tips and tricks that I use to complete the Phantom Rig, and I think I got the Phantom Rig done in 2 days. I think a day, actually. Probably a day or 2 days, one of those, but that's actually really short. But without further ado, let's get right into the video. First off, I'm going to showcase the Phantom Rig in Gold, Diamond, Solar, and Black Sky to see if you guys actually want to go for Black Sky on the rigs, because for some reason, the Phantom Rig with Black Sky is like glitched out. The lighting is like really glitched out on it, but Black Sky is really, really dark on the Phantom Rig, and I don't know why, but Black Sky does not pop out at all on this rig. On all the other rigs, it's perfect, but on this rig, it's just the lighting screwed up. But the rig looks really good in solar, so I recommend getting solar for this rig. Like, all the rigs look really good in solar, but Black Sky, this is probably the only rig that's not worth getting Black Sky for. But all the other rigs are worth it, but just not this rig because the lighting glitch, bro. But before I get into the challenges, I'm going to talk about the gameplay in this video. So I might not show all the gameplay, but it is Dom on the XP Turista map. God, I missed that. I don't know why they ended it. Turista was an okay map for me, but I loved the XP. But this game was like, we just destroyed them. I don't know why, but we just absolutely destroyed them. And by the end of the game, I think like most of the enemies and people on my team were like no prestiges. So I was like, wow, these people are new to Infinite Warfare, or they probably reset their stats, you never know. But we just absolutely destroyed the enemy team, and I used the Volt Corruption like this whole time, if I'm correct. And like, some people got mad that I was using the Volt Corruption and they used it against me, or picked up my Volt or something like that because I was doing so good and they wanted to see how I was doing so good. Just people do that when they like see me just merc everybody in the game. They just pick up my gun and they see if they can merc them, and I just go over there and merc them with the gun they picked up. It's just if you see me in a game and you're in a game with me and I'm not recording, or I'm recording, just know, rip. That's all you gotta know is rip. But enough of that, let's get into the challenges for the Phantom Rig. So I'm gonna start off with the heads. So the first challenge for the head is Granite, kill 200 enemies while using the Phantom Combat Rig. That is actually pretty self-explanatory. The next one's Tundra, kill 400 enemies while using the Phantom Combat Rig. That one's self-explanatory as well. Next one's Multicam, get 50 double kills while using the Phantom Combat Rig. Now, this should be self-explanatory, but there's no easy ways to getting double kills. But if you want to know how long it takes for the double kill to go away, where it doesn't register when you get another kill, it takes approximately 2 seconds. So once you kill somebody, just count 2 seconds, and if you don't kill somebody in under those 2 seconds, it won't count as a double kill. Next one's Europa, get 100 double kills while using the Phantom Combat Rig. That's basically what I said about multicam. Next one's Mantis, kill 3 enemies without dying while using the Phantom Combat Rig 30 times. Now, this should be easy, but if you're having trouble, use the stealth perks in camp. That's my best explanation I can go for you guys, is use all the stealth perks, Blind Eye, Ghost, Cold Blooded, and Dead Silence, and just camp. Or if you don't like camping and you can rush, then just go ahead and rush and hope for the best, because getting this should be easy. But again, if it's not, just camp, and don't camp just to be a douche. Camp because you're trying to get this rig diamond. Next one is Sand Dune, kill 3 enemies without dying while using the Phantom Combat Rig 60 times. Basically what I said about Mantis. Next one's Wildwood, activate a Phantom Combat Rig payload 60 times. That's pretty self-explanatory. And to unlock gold, you have to get all the pieces for the category. So if you want gold on the body parts, you have to unlock all the body parts. If you want gold on the heads, you have to unlock all the heads. And to get diamond, you have to unlock everything in the rig. So if you want diamond, you have to unlock all the heads and body pieces, and you get diamond. In solar, you have to unlock all the pieces for every rig, And Black Sky, you had to have all the pieces unlocked for every rig, and you got to get 5 kills with each rig in a single game. Now we are done with the heads, it is off to the body parts. So the first one's Granite, killed 2 enemies with a single ballista shot one time. Now this one I think is the hardest challenge ever. Like, it probably seems like it's easy, but this can be hard because not a lot of people line up in Infinite Warfare because everybody's just like boost jumping all over the place. But what will really help with getting this is playing Domination. And the reason why is because multiple people cap flags if they're like team players, and just take out the sniper, line them up, or actually it'll line up for you. Like, the sniper has like aimbot on it, so line up for you and just shoot and you'll get them. That's the easiest way I can tell you guys how to get this challenge done. And then the next one is Tundra, get 25 melee kills while using the active camo. So this shouldn't be hard at all, but if you want to know the easiest way to do this, obviously use a combat knife. Just focus on this challenge. Don't do anything else. Don't care about KD or win loss or anything like that. Just focus on this challenge and play a long game mode like Domination. You can play hardcore if you want to, but it's gonna be way harder, so watch out with that. But focus on this challenge. So use combat knife and use overclock. I forgot to announce that. Use overclock when getting the melee kills so you can get them like way faster and all that with active camo. But just know, if you do miss a knife with the combat knife, the active camo will go away, because the active camo goes away when you hit once or shoot once or anything like that. So once you get your first kill while you're in active camo, it will instantly go away, so you can't get multiple ones. So that's where overclock will come in handy. Next one's multicam, get 50 kills while using active camo. Basically what I said about Tundra. Next one is Mantis, kill 2 enemies with a single activation of Pulsar 10 times. This shouldn't be hard, but I think if you activate Pulsar, you can see the enemies for, I think it's like 4 to 6 seconds, somewhere there. But just know that once you instantly activate Pulsar, just keep rushing to those guys. And activate Pulsar in places where enemies will be at. So play Dom. If you play Dom, you will find, or you can play Ground War for this actually. Ground War will be easier for this, not Dom. Ground War. And the reason why Ground War is because there's way more people on the map. So if you activate Pulsar, there'll be more orange people on the map than usual. So just know, when you activate Pulsar, go for them. Go for 2 people as fast as possible, and don't care about any other people. Just target 2 people and just murk them. Next one is Sand Dune, kill 2 enemies with a single activation of Pulsar 25 times. Basically what I said about Mantis. Next one's Europa, kill 10 enemies after they damage your rearguard shield. Now, this will be good for Ground War 2, and it's pretty easy. It actually is pretty easy. There's no tips to this because it's actually really easy. Just let somebody shoot you in the back. Like, finesse them by going like inside of a room or something, wait for them to come to you, and then kill them. You only have to do it 10 times. Like, that's not that hard. But play Ground War. Next one is Wildwood, kill 25 enemies after they damage your rear guard shield. Basically, you only have to do this 15 times. You want to do it 15 times because once you do it 10 times, it should count towards Wildwood. Yeah, it should count towards Wildwood when you're going for Europa. So you only have to do it 15 more times. And just basically what I said about Europa, just play Ground War and just let somebody shoot you in the back, finesse them, and then boom, get the kill. And I already told you how to get Gold, Diamond, Solar, and Black Sky, but that is basically pretty much it for this video, guys. And I hope you guys did like this, because if you did, drop a like, it helps me out a ton. And if you're new to the channel, subscribe for more amazing content, upload every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Also, comment down below if you have any tips towards the Phantom rig that I didn't know of or anything like that, because you never know if that tip could be better than one of mine or anything like that, and I would actually really love to hear it, and it could help somebody out. Also, I will pop a card to the Diamond Rig or Easy Diamond Rig Tricks whatever playlist right about now, and I'll put it in the description below if you want to check it out after this video. Again, remember, I did the Warfighter, Merc, Synaptic, FTL, and Striker Rig. So they're all done now, and also Phantom. But that was pretty much it for this video, guys, and I'll see you in my next one. So stay amazing, and peace, guys.